You are at the right place if you want to understand what the byte pair encoding subword tokenization algorithm is, how to train it, and how the tokenization of a text is done with this algorithm. The BPE algorithm was initially proposed as a text compression algorithm, but it is also very well suited as a tokenizer for your language models. The idea of BPE is to divide words into a sequence of subword units, which are units that appear frequently in a reference corpus, which is the corpus we use to train it. How is a BPE tokenizer trained? First of all, we have to get a corpus of text. We will not train our tokenizer on this raw text, but we will first normalize it, then pre-tokenize it. As the pre-tokenization divides the text into a list of words, we can represent a corpus in another way, by gathering together the same words and by maintaining a counter, here represented in blue. To understand how the training works, we consider this stock corpus composed of the following words: hugging face, hugging, hug, hugger, etc. BPE is an algorithm that starts with an initial vocabulary and then increases it to the desired size. To build the initial vocabulary, we start by separating each word of the corpus into a list of elementary units that compose them. Here, the characters. We list in our vocabulary all the characters that appear and that will constitute our initial vocabulary. Let's now see how to increase it. We return to our split corpus. We will go through the words one by one and count all the occurrences of token pairs. The first pair is composed of the token H and U. The second, U and G. And we continue like this until we have the complete list. Once we know all the pairs on their frequency of appearance, we will choose the one that appears the most frequently. Here it is a pair composed of the letters L and E. We note our first merging rule, and we add a new token to our vocabulary. We can then apply this merging rule to our splits. You can see that we have merged all the pairs of tokens composed of the tokens L and E. And now, we just have to reproduce the same steps with our new splits. We calculate the frequency of occurrence of each pair of tokens. We select the pair with the highest frequency. We note it in our merge rules. We add the new token to the vocabulary, and then we merge all the pairs of tokens composed of the token Li and A into our splits. And we can repeat this operation until we reach the desired vocabulary size. Here, we stopped when our vocabulary reached 21 tokens. We can see now that the words of our corpus are now divided into far fewer tokens than had at the beginning of the training, and that our algorithm has learned the radicals hug and learn, and also the verbal ending, ing. Now that we have learned our vocabulary and merging rules, we can tokenize next text. New text. For example, if we want to tokenize the word hugs, first we will divide it into elementary units so it begins a sequence of characters. Then we'll go through our merge rules until we have one we can apply. Here we can merge the letter H and U. On here we can merge two tokens to get the new token hug. When we get to the end of our merge rules, the tokenization is finished. And that's it. I hope that now the BPO algorithm has no more secret for you.